Hello, Rad. My name is Uber, and I would like to welcome you, as Dracula is showing up, in Castlevania, Lords of Shadow 2. I just finished recording Castlevania, Lords of Shadow, Mirror of Fate, so sequel to Lords of Shadow and prequel to this game. And, oh boy, that was interesting experience. That was 2D platformer. Very different art style and so on and so on. It doesn't matter, but pretty important, I think, at least in terms of the story. But what is important at the end of that game, Mirror Fate, Gabriel, Dracula, that you can see here, is dead. So what the fuck happened? How he managed to survive that? I don't know, but it doesn't matter, I guess. Right now we're playing this game that I have very high hopes for. I haven't played it. I mean, okay, that's technically a lie. I played it like 2 or 3 minutes just to see if everything is recording all right, if the audio is all right, if there are subtitles, and so on and so on. But I skipped all the cutscenes and I just went to the first fight and just, you know, had a little bit of fun with killing enemies there. So yeah, I really like Lords of Shadow 1. Other than that final boss fight with Forgotten One, that was fucking annoying. Because it was just amazing story. Pretty good gameplay also. There are a few aspects that were pretty annoying. And we'll see if that will be the case in here. And in terms of Lords of Shadow, Mirror of Fate, I also had a lot of fun. But as I said, there are a few annoying things. It doesn't matter. I was playing those games because of the story. Because I wanted to check out some Castlevania games. Oh, what's going on? Okay, Konami, tell me what's going on. We got some sort of like... Oh. Hello? Excuse me, what's going on? Oh, we had nice obscured view of Dracula. Great. That looks fucking amazing. That looks fucking amazing with all the cutscenes look like that. That would be pretty cool. Okay, and he is walking through the castle where we killed Carmilla. So Bernard's castle, right? Like a boss. Oh, there is a siege at his castle. Okay. Those are warriors from the Brotherhood. At least from what I gathered at the beginning of the game. Oh, fuck yeah. No. Nice. Come here, fuckers. Dracula is coming for you. Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, that's amazing. He's like Shadow Whip. Holy shit, we're attacking everyone out. They stand no chance, absolutely no chance. We got a big fucker, not a problem. What is that? That is Titan, right? Of some sorts. Well, shit. Oh, fuck yeah. It was worth the wait. And he just healed himself or what? Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, fuck yeah. That's amazing. Okay, it was worth waiting for that. It was worth talking like that. Nice. And that's Alucard. Well. Okay. And Alucard will be fighting with Dracula. Okay. Just like in the Mirror of Fate. Okay, and we are going back to that. Okay, that was really good to see. Also, I wanted to point out that this book, looks very similar to the book from the first game where we had that Mask of God at the cover. Broken Mask of God at the cover later on. So yeah, that's pretty amazing. So as I said, I have pretty high hopes for this game, but in the comments you guys said that the cutscenes were pretty much a copyright strike guarantee for this game. So we'll see all about that, but for right now, enough talking, let's start the game. Let's go. Okay, automatic save points, that's a little bit shitty. If I will lose a footage from the game, if I will lose the video, then I've got fucking nothing to go back to. So that's a little bit annoying, but let's just hope that everything will be alright. Also, we'll be playing this game with all the DLCs that are available for this game, because I've got like Ultimate Edition, whatever it is called, it doesn't matter. So we've got one cosmetic change, that is, we've got new costume that we can play with, but we'll not be checking that out. We've also got Revelations DLC, I think that's the only like story DLC of the game. We've got some sort of like runic pack and souls pack, I don't remember what that is, it doesn't matter. But basically they're giving us some sort of advantage in the game. For right now, let's go in. Oh, fuck yeah. I'm Dracul. Dracul means dragon, from what I remember, right? Prince of Darkness. Let's go. Oh, fuck yeah. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's block that. Oh, blocking is not essential, come on. Nice, now let's fuck him up. What, we failed? What? Okay, fuck you game then. Come on. Oh, come on, I was holding that, you saw that. Okay, attack me one more time. Come on, attack me, someone. Come on, attack me. Let's go, come on. Hey, how did we fail the first one? I don't understand that really. Okay, let's go with those area attacks. Because we've got few enemies that we've got to take care of. Okay, this unlockable attack. Dodged, avoided. Okay. We didn't have that ability to dodge attacks before, so that's interesting. Oh shit, okay, quick recovery. I think that we had to fail on that. Okay, let's go. Oh, dodging in this game will be for sure much better than the previous one. I can already see that we've got much longer range of those. Oh, we can feed on the enemies to recover health. Okay. Okay. Okay, so there is a little bit of a quick time event with that. And they're just looking at us as we are taking blood from the friend. That's fucking great. Okay, let's go. Okay, you want to play like that? Let's fucking play like that. Okay. Let's go. I like to drink your blood. Would you? Let's go. Okay, let's go. Let's drink. Nice. There's not like terrible amount of hell, but alright. Okay. Let's go. Use the Void Sword to steal life from your enemies. What? Void Sword. How are you getting that? Oh, fuck yeah. That's our life magic, huh? Okay, let's go. Also, we haven't saw how they are going inside the castle. That's a little bit annoying. And did we miss a cutscene? Because I already played the game. Technically played. I do wonder about it. Shouldn't we see him like sitting on the throne or something like that? Okay, let's see. Let's. I try to drink your blood, but nope. We've got shield guy. I hate shield guys. Okay. Use Chaos Claws to break your. Okay, we've got Claws of Chaos. Like Dark Gauntlet. Okay, let's go. Let's fucking go. Nice. Okay. Oh, we just destroyed him. Okay, we've got more guys. That's great. Okay, use your Void Sword. Okay, let's fucking go. Let's take out the shields first. Okay, let's see. There is another guy with shield. Let's go. Nice. Okay. Let's see. Let's go back with that. Nice. Okay, let's fucking go. Time to play with your fuckers. Oh, come on. Come at me, bro. We can have a lot of fun together. Nice, let's fucking go, just like that. Oh, fuck yeah. Nice. We don't need that health from that guy, so fuck that. Nice. Oh, he was struggling with that? Come on, you are amazing strong. Okay, now you go back. Okay, couldn't we just go up through the top? Okay, we cannot go back, that's great. Okay, we don't have ability to double jump, unfortunately, that sucks. Okay, we've got bats. And we've got parkour, great. Exactly what I wanted. Okay. Oh shit. Shit. Okay, great. Let's see. Left trigger highlights your path. Okay. That's cool. Okay, let's go. Nice, and then let's go there. Okay, let's go. For sure, excuse me. For sure, parkour system in this game is a little bit more cinematic, I would guess. Because, well, it's more cinematic than previous game. That is not to say that in previous game it wasn't cinematic at all. it was pretty good then. And we were seeing quite a lot of good views and so on. But in here, as you can see, there is a lot of movement in environment that we can see. So that will make for an interesting gameplay, I guess. Okay, it's time to kick some ass. Oh, fuck yeah, that's what we saw. Nice. Okay, it looks a little bit different. Worse quality, that's for sure. Well, hello, fucker. Fuck yeah. Fuck that guy. He looks fucking amazing, but still, fuck that guy. That's our first boss fight, I guess. What the fuck? Who the fuck are you? God is with me, monster. That will be your ruin. Oh, fuck you. Okay, we've got our health in the left right corner, left up corner, and we've got his health on the top right. Okay, let's go. Okay, fuck you. Oh, back to where you came from, you fucker. You are coming to my house. So fuck you. Okay, let's go. Nice, let's go. Fuck. Let's go. Okay, but who the fuck is that fucker? How he's got those fucking wings? Shit, where he will drop? Okay, right here, let's go. Nice. Let's go, nice. Beautiful. Beautiful. Let's go. Okay, and he's running away. Great. Okay, can we kill the big guy, big fucker first? But who is he, though? That is what I would like to know. Oh, fuck yeah. This game is for sure much more cinematic than the first one. Okay, second part of this fight. That guy looks fucking amazing. And right now we were going back to the shitty little knights. Oh, you can fucking try. Okay, let's go. Leave my castle alone, you fuckers. Okay. Excuse me, I was trying to fucking jump. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's fucking go. Okay, let's drink you. I mean, let's drink your blood. Let's suck you. Oh. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, I guess we've got to do it again. Probably we'll have one more time if he'll be trying to break the castle. And you just have to jump. Shit. And they all died. You killed your own. What? Let's go. Thank you very much. We managed to hold that. Oh, come on. I was doing that. Oh, we are doing that again? What? That's great and all, but what the fuck? Okay, we're going back to that part. Great and all. And that's pretty annoying. Okay, let's go. Come on! What the fuck? Oh, fuck you, game. Don't you give me a damage like that. Excuse me, what? Okay, controls are a little bit wonky, that's for sure. Okay, let's go a little bit higher. Okay, let's go. Excuse me. What the fuck? Okay, we'll spend a little bit of time here trying to deduce what is good timing in here and what isn't. Okay, let's fucking go. Okay, back to the... back down. I guess that we've got to go way up there. Okay, let's see. Let's do it again. I pressed it at the right time. Fuck you, game. That's really fucking annoying. If you ask me. Okay, let's go. Thank you very much. Okay, let's go up. At least let's try to. Okay, let's go again. I pushed that at the right fucking time. Excuse me, game. We'll spend a little bit of time here, it seems. Okay, let's fucking go. Again, I would like to point out. That is just fucking annoying. Okay, let's go, let's go. Now I nailed that. Beautiful. Okay, another one. Nice. Okay, that brace is gone, so right now we can move higher. And that's where we've got to go. Great. So let's fucking go. Excuse me, game. Excuse me, game. Okay, down we go, up we go. That's fucking great. Oh, fuck you, Gandalf. Okay. Okay, fuck you. Let's go. Nice. Okay, now we've got to go to the left and the right ones. Fuck. That's a long way to go. Great. Nice, one more, fucker. Nice. Thank you very much. We are destroying your own Titan. That's fucking great. Okay. Okay, game. We've got to go to the middle. Great, let's jump. Okay, what right now? Up we go. What am I supposed to do here? Okay. Fuck you. Okay, let's see. Oh, I just went straight into that, haven't I? What the fuck just happened? Excuse me. Okay. Let's go back. That golden fucker is pretty... Okay, that golden fucker is pretty annoying, not gonna lie. And as I said before, parkour in this game, in previous game, is not that great. Nice. Okie dokie. Thank you very much. Okay, where the fuck are we going? Fuck me. Fuck me, I guess. Okay, how was I supposed to go through that location? I don't know, still. Okay. Nice. Beautiful. Up we go, all the way around. That's fucking great. Okay, what are we supposed to do? Go up here? Yes. Exactly what we are supposed to do. How am I supposed to break that? Okay. Okay, let's go. fuck. Okay. Nice. Okay, that's how you're supposed to do it. Okay. Okay, fuck you. Okay, let's go with that. Oh, you can fucking try. Okay, let me suck your blood. And I mean suck your blood, not you. Let's go. Nice. Come on. Oh, fuck, I forgot that. When he's aiming. Nice. Nice. I sacrificed a little bit of health, but it was worth it. Okay, beautiful. Okay, come here, fucker. Let's go. Okay, let's go. Beautiful. Fuck you. We've got the last one to go through. Okay, let's go again. Nice. Okay. Okay, we're very close to that. Excuse me, game. Let's do it. Nice. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you all. Okay, let's go. Fuck, I was trying to suck that guy. Let's go. Okay, let's go. Come on. Okay, I tried to suck him, but nope. Okay, we'll have to use that void sword, that's for sure. Okay, let's wait. Shit, shit. Okay, where are we going right now? Okay, to the left, I guess. Okay, that guy is pretty fucking annoying. Let's go back. Okay, let's go right here. Nice. For fuck's sake. Okay, we've got to go here. That's fucking great. And we've got more runes to destroy. Crystals, runes, whatever. Okay, let's fucking go. Oh, we are very low on health. I cannot see shit. I was fucking dodging that. Okay, let's return to the last checkpoint. I guess that it was when we were going up. Okay, great. Oh, we are back in here. Oh, that's a little bit annoying. But alright. Come on, up we go. Excuse me, game. What the fuck was that supposed to be? Okay, as I said before, parkour is a little bit irritating in this game. Okay, let's go. Nice. Let's go again. Okay, let's go. Beautiful. At least I know right now where we've got to go. Okay, let's go. Come on, shoot me right now. Shoot me right fucking now. Okay. Let's see, let's destroy your fucking shield. Okay, come here. Nice, good job, fucker. Okay, let's fucking go. Nice. Okay, let's drink your blood. Nice, thank you very much. Beautiful. Okay, let's go back, let's destroy your fucking shields. You don't fucking need it, believe me. Oh, fuck you. Okay. Nice. Okay, let's go. Let's steal a little bit of health from you. Let's go. Oh! He magically respawned that fucking shield. That's great. Okay, let's suck you. Nice. Okie dokie, great. Nice. Okay, let's go back here. Let's turn off our magic right now. Let's fucking go. Okay, destroy that crystal. Holy fuck! We are just vomiting. Oh, we are cursing that. Right? Why we had to vomit? Why we had to vomit that? Could we just break that crystal? Okay, hello fuckers, you are going down. Okay, let me drink my tea. Let's hope there will be no quick time event during that. Good job, fuckers. Good job. Nice. So we broke down that Titan. Let's hope that we haven't broke down anything from our body. Where are we? Because right now we are seeing only the dead knights. Where are we? Well, right down here. Great. Nice. Can we suck blood of those corpses? Hello, gold fucker. Take him out. Okay. Okay. Fuck you too. That's what I was meant to say. Let's go. Okay, at least he doesn't have full health. Because very often we've got those recurring boss fights, I mean returning boss fights, then they also return with full fucking health. Okay. What the fuck was that supposed to be? Okay. That's fucking great. Okay, let's go. Okay, we're going again with that. That's a little bit annoying. Back to fuck you, demon. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Yeah, oh. I know. Okay, let's go. What? Excuse me, game, what the fuck? Let's break his defense. Nice. That's exactly what we are supposed to do with that beautiful magic. Oh, we'll see about that. Let's go. Okay. He's got a shit ton of health right now. Oh, how he was able to attack us. Okay. Let's go. Okay, that's the one we've got to jump. I fucking dodged that, but alright. Okay, let's go. Fuck, fuck, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me, fuck me, fuck you too. Yeah, I know. But... oh, come on. Why he gets sometimes attack that we can fucking dodge by just dodging. Sometimes we've got to jump up, sometimes dodge to the left, to the right. Okay, let's fucking go. Okay, let's fucking go. Oh, fuck you too. Fuck you too. Nice. Let's go. Give me that fucking health. Oh, come on, I was fucking dodging. Okay, let's fucking go. Nice, let's go. Okay, let's break your fucking defense. Nice. Let's push as much as we can in. We'll see about that. You are going to fucking die. Let's go. Nice. Okay, fuck you. Give me that health. Okay, let's fucking go. Okay, let's go. Nice. I forgot that I can block his attacks also. Okay, we've got that fucking attack. That's great. Okay, great. Let's go. Nice. Let's go. Come on, come here, you fucker. God damn it, stop running away. Come on. I was outside of the hitbox of that attack. Let's fucking go. You've got a lot of health. You've got also very shitty attacks. Oh, we'll see about that. Let's go. Let's break your fucking defense. Okay, let's fucking go. Let's fucking go. Nice. Okie dokie. Nice. Come here. You fucker. Oh yeah, we'll see about that. Okay, let's fucking go. Nice. Fuck. Oh, beautiful. Who the fuck are you? Well, oh fuck yeah, we use power of God. Oh fuck yeah. We destroyed him with the power of a god. Holy fuck. That was pretty fucking powerful, not gonna lie. And we got that cross. Beautiful. Tell me that we haven't destroyed our castle. Oh, we've got dark cross right now or something like that. Oh, broken cross. I meant to say. Holy shit. Nice. Oh, hello, son. Okay, what's going on? Black screen, great. And we are saving.
Whoever defeats the Lords of Shadow will sit upon their throne to rule as the Prince of Darkness.
Before fate had played its hand, and unknown to Gabriel, his beloved wife, Marie, conceived a son by him. The Brotherhood of Light warned her of that ancient prophecy and the terrible fate which lay before her husband. So, with heavy heart, she concealed her pregnancy. For it is written that only the blood of that lineage has the power to defeat the Prince of Darkness. Thus, when newly born, the child Trevor was hidden from his father and raised a holy warrior of the Brotherhood in secret, so that one day he would be ready to stand against his own blood, as foretold. That day came, some 25 years later, for what had once been Gabriel Belmont was now a powerful vampire known as Dracula, the Dragon. The Brotherhood of Light fought against the onslaught of his dark armies, which laid waste to towns and villages across the land, but to little avail. Trevor was now fully grown to manhood, and the truth of his origin and destiny of the Belmont clan was finally revealed to him. So he set out to confront his father and end his family shame forever. But Trevor failed and was mortally wounded in the confrontation with his father. He was no match for Dracula's terrible power. Yet, as he lay dying, Trevor finally revealed his true identity. Dracula was driven mad with grief and rage over the revelation. He desperately sought to save his dying son by giving him his own lifeblood. But it was too late, or so he thought. Dracula buried his son within the walls of his great castle, and then swore bloody vengeance upon the world. Raising an army of creatures beholden only to him, he struck with fury and merciless cruelty at humanity. He vowed to hunt God's children for all eternity. But fate still had one last card to play. Dracula's blood had power, and that power now coursed through the veins of his dead son, slowly reviving him over many years, until one night he emerged once more into the world, not as a man, but as a creature like his father. What had once been Trevor Belmont was now gone forever. He was now a vampire like his father, though he swore that he would not be like him. He would take the name Alucard. He would be a force for good, opposing his father's capacity for evil. In that very moment, Alucard swore to destroy Dracula. But fate had something else in mind. Meanwhile, Trevor's own son grew into a fearsome warrior with a reputation that far exceeded even that of his illustrious father. Simon Belmont knew little of his own lineage, nor his importance in the events to come. All he knew was that his mother had died at the hands of Dracula's minions when he was but an infant, and his father had been killed in single combat with Dracula. Found and raised by the people of White Mountains, Simon had but one purpose in life: to destroy Dracula for the murder of his parents. After years of training in the arts of war, Simon set off for Dracula's castle and a date with destiny. Once in the castle, Simon met Alucard, and knowing little of the true identity of his companion, joined forces with him. Blood bound them together, and fate took a hand once again, as finally they met their dreaded foe in mortal combat. Simon defeated Dracula with his whip, and yet Alucard sensed that all was not as it should be. Dracula would return.
Okay, what the fuck just happened? Because there were so many wrong things with that. Not a whip, but with combat cross. Also, they weren't companions because they were just missing each other. Only trained for the last fight. Also, okay, there are a few more things, but that was just weird. Also, the prophecy was not like, at least we haven't known it to be like that. The prophecy of Lords of Shadow, the Little Dark Prince, but also in Mirror of Fate, the game told us that it was shown by Mirror of Fate, not by prophecy. So what the fuck? Also, Trevor hasn't chosen the name of Alucard. Dracula chose it for him. Holy fuck. No, so that's how we returned many centuries later for that end credits for the Lords of Shadow 1. Well, that's fucking great. But it took us so long to resurrect. And we've got Return of Patrick Stewart as Zobek. Beautiful, amazing actor. Amazing voice actor for Zobek, that's for sure. Okay, and that's where we are meeting him in the that end credits scene. So that already happened? What?
And what have you? Why have you been hiding all this time? Gabriel.
Don't you dare call me that. Isn't Dracul.
So we died for the second time, or we're just taking a nap? What is going on?
What do you want? Old friend.
Satan's acolytes are readying for his imminent return. Help me stop him. Or you and I will become his favorite pets. For all eternity.
Okay, but we already saw that. And you've got Mother Ward right after that. But still, what's going on? Don't tell me that we'll just get out. Oh, dressing those robes, that's amazing. That's a really good plan, Gabriel. Have we died for the second time, or we're just taking a nap in that coffin? Okay, no one will even notice us. Come on, they will do something. That must be very weird word for him. But now probably he already saw everything and so on. Because he had to live through all those years.
Help me, and I can free you of your immortality.
Simon? Trevor? 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 What? I mean, he looked like...
Please,
I can suck your blood. He He looks like young Simon, but he has dark hair like Trevor. Nope. Oh, hello, lady. Can we do something with her? Hello, hello? Not really, not really. Okay, let's return then to chasing Trevor slash Simon. What's going on with that, huh? I cannot go any faster. That is for sure a trap. But who is trying to kill us? What's going on over there? What the fuck? Who the fuck are you? Okay, let's fucking go. I don't have that whip right now. Okay. Great. Oh, don't tell me that he will just beat us like that. Come on, where is our whip? Where is our fucking sword? Where is our ability to dodge? I cannot even fucking dodge. Oh, come on. Game, what the fuck is going on? What the fuck? Who the fuck is that guy? What the fuck is going on? At least he saved us, but what the fuck is going on? Oh, we'll drink their blood. Oh, we'll drink. Oh, shit. Oh, we need to drink their blood. Holy shit, let's go. Let's fucking go. We also killed the child? Probably. Let's go. And we can also drink the blood from the dad, you know? He still has blood warm. I mean, warm blood, that's what I was trying to say. Okay, and we'll be healing, right? Oh, the game is hiding that. And we just drink her blood. Beautiful. So right now we'll be young and powerful again, I guess. But who just helped us? Okay, nice. Who the fuck are you? Oh, we look very good. Hello, Zobek. How are you doing?
It pleases me to see you recovered, old friend.
Indeed, old friend.
No!
That's fucking great sword.
Our guest is just a little confused. I know what he wants. You see before you the legendary vampire killer. Your old weapon, if you recall. The only weapon capable of ending your immortal life. You thought it destroyed. But you see, you can have the eternal rest you crave after all.
It will disappear? No, that's illusion. Fuck.
But first, you must help me. Prevent Satan's return to the world. Then, I swear to you, I will deliver the fatal blow to your heart.
And I am sure you will fulfill that vow.
Since you sent Satan back to hell 1,000 years ago, his human offspring, or acolytes as they call themselves, have been dormant. I suppose that they, that all of us, feared your wrath and great power. But not now. Now, even my bodyguard is more than a match for you. The acolytes know you are weak and are preparing for their father's return. Now they fear nothing.
Don't they fear the mighty Zobek?
Only you, in full possession of your powers, can defeat them. Follow me.
Why we are so weak, though? Because we were really fucking powerful at that beginning of the game.
We must find and destroy the acolytes before they can finalize their preparations for Satan's return. It won't be easy. They govern the world of men from the shadows. Not even I know with any degree of certainty who or where they are. They won't come out into the light unless we can force their hand. The acolytes must never know who hunts them down. The element of surprise will give us the advantage. Until you are at full strength again.
And you don't know who they are or where they are.
Do you know that this city is built upon the foundations of your castle? The acolytes are focusing their attentions here for very good reason. Satan has specifically chosen this place for his return. He means to enslave you first, to humiliate you for what you did to him.
Let's get
on. Oh, fuck yeah. Nice. But why we are so weak, I would like to know. Because that's just a little bit confusing. And I guess right now we've got to get our powers back, but why we lost them?
The acolytes must plunge the world into chaos before Satan can be summoned. Their activities leave spectral traces, which are difficult but not impossible to follow. This is the headquarters of a powerful pharmaceutical corporation. I suspect that one of the acolytes is operating from there. The complex was sealed 2 months ago and is protected by magic. If I were to use my powers to see what is happening there, they would be able to trace it back to me within a matter of minutes. So, I will send you to the corporation via a portal.
but we must be quick so as not to arouse suspicion. The longer the portal remains open, the more likely we will be discovered. Look for any sign of the acolyte, but be careful.
What are you waiting for?
Okay, let's go. That's a little bit weird. I'm not sure I understand everything correctly. And we are just going in like that. Well, that's fucking great. Where are we being teleported to? Holy shit, that's really high up. And this fucking street on this level. Okay, and we'll be teleported right over there, probably, right? Right around the corner. Well, that's not suspicious at all. Giant monolith showing up from the ground. Beautiful. Nice. Oh, we got back our powers. Oh, fuck yeah. Nice. Okay, beautiful. Can now check our travel book. Okay, let's check that out. So travel book map, use it to find the submissions on a time. Okay, must investigate Bioquimic Corporation. Okay, items. So items page, travel book. Okay. What we've got? We've got Heart. Heart of Dracula. When Gabriel replaced his blood with Laura's, a change began that went beyond his the purely physical drowning out of love, compassion, and tenderness that filled the man's heart, giving way to the merciless darkness of the dragon. It is supernatural power that, fed by the blood of his victims, flows through his veins, healing the wounds inflicting lead on him and wronging the torturous curse for all eternity. Okay, interesting. Shadow Whip. Oh, we've got that Shadow Whip again. Nice. Gabriel's deeply rooted training with the combat cross remained in Dracula. The Prince of Darkness now uses his own blood, which takes the shape of Sinus Whip, to inflict pain and death wherever he goes. The dark fluid is bound by supernal force and it hardens on impact. Before they die, this victim feels its thousands of fangs penetrate the flesh, breaking bones and tearing the life force from them. Great. No more items. Okay, but I guess because you've got those little like crystals going first of all through the heart and also to the two circles on both left and right, that probably means and that will have both light and shadow magic on the left and right. But we also will be able to upgrade that Heart of Dracula that I don't know yet what he's doing, but probably will be doing some sort of like finishers, quick time events, whatever. Lore. This is lore of the okay, Belmont lineage. So we'll learn more about the Belmont lineage, okay. Dracula, not even his descendants, the Belmonts, nor the innumerable army of the Brotherhood of Light, even come close to annihilating him. He is Dracula the Dragon, an immortal being whose cursed soul is condemned to remain trapped in the body of the vampire, bound to this castle for all eternity. From the beginning, the unbearable yearning of revenge has driven him along the path of iron and destruction, a path of infinite suffering and despair, a road that he would now like to leave behind. That is why the power of your god cannot destroy him, because I am his chosen one. Yeah, and we cannot die. Brotherhood of Light. Brotherhood soldier. Okay, fuck that, I'm not interested in that. Paladin. That's interesting. Those who aspire to be paladins are raised in monasteries, educated under the dogma of faith and trained in the art of war. Their whole life becomes a test in which any mistake, and as insignificant as it may be, leads to complete failure of their mission. Only the purest heart, capable of showing absolute determination, are on a swearing faith, we recognize as God's chosen one. You will receive the admiration of all and the favor of the Council of Brotherhood of Light. The paladins are rewarded with the weapons and armor of gold, forged by the Bear's Master Blacksmith from Angel Bones. Their aim from then until the end of their day is to serve God in the battle against the offspring of evil and guide their troops to victory. I was like you once, but your God showed me another path, Dracula. And we got Siege Titan. That was fucking amazing looking. With the upsurge of battles between Brotherhood of Light and the forces of darkness, the engineers of the Holy Order quickly completed the last great work of the Gandolfi, the Siege Titan. His giant wood and metal automaton, inspired by the stone giant of that the force of Agartha commanded in the Necromancer Wars. For over a decade, hundreds of craftsmen worked to complete this mechanism, powered by the divine energy of the gem that the priest placed in its head. In battle, it would be ready to use it on its extremities, smashing a regiment with a single stamp of foot, pulverizing the walls of the castle with its fist, and dispatching a group of soldiers inside. Its value in war was such that only after it was built did the Brotherhood decide to start the siege of Dracula's castle, one with enough to set in motion, destroy it. A huge master engineer. Okay, we've got Zobek Society. Zobek. So we have multiple beings from that Zobek Society. Okay. Zobek was together with Carmilla and Cornel, one of the old founders of the Brotherhood of Light, who answered the call of the God, leaving their darkest being on the earth, the Lord of Death. However, despite his absolute mastery of necromantic magic, could do nothing against the supremacy of Satan, and his existence was relegated to the kingdom of the lifeless. Exhausted and humiliated, he remained hidden for an era, watching over the world of men through his countless spies, extending his influence and preparing his return, where he learned that the power of Dracula has weakened enough and that the arrival of Satan was near. Zobek materialized once again on Earth. He left behind the arrogance of his past to take on the role of an influential businessman, and he blended in directly with society up to present. Now he has a new plan, a perfect plan that will put his two worst enemies against one another, leaving only his Zobek to become Lord of All once and for all. You can have all the eternal rest you so crave. Okay, we already heard that. Who is that guy? No one knows the identity of the man accompanying the Asut Zobek in his crusade for power. It is rumored that he wears armor forged from the metal extracted from the abyss, and that he adeptly brandishes a mystical sword by name of Masamune, capable of going beyond the material realm. Some records indicate that he is the spirit of the damned general. Others that he is a demon that must pay a debt to death. However, the most popular story is that the one that classifies him as a result of necromantic reanimation of legendary armor. After all, it would not be the first time that Zobek used witchcraft to create powerful armed guard. Zobek sent me. He feels you might need to my help as you are still weak. Okay, great. Let's go to map. We've got that. Skills. Is the skill page. Okay. What we've got here? Shadow Whip. Mastery level. Mastery level? What? Okay, so probably the more we'll fight with that, the more... No, we just have to upgrade that like that. What the fuck is going on? That's a lot to take in. Basic actions, attack, jump, and so on and so on. Okay. Doesn't matter. Okay. Very, very fucking interesting. Also, let's see, we've got additional content. Dracula or Armor Dracula. Let's go with that. That should restart us from the checkpoint. I just wanted to show you that outfit. How that looks. Okay. I've got to go through all of that again. Okay, come on, read the book. Okay. Please tell me that I don't have to do everything again. Biochemic Corporation, let's go. Okay. Oh, yeah, I know that. Fuck, I didn't know that we'd have to do all of that again. But that is Armored Dracula costume. It doesn't look that different. And it's a little bit different. Okay, maybe we'll go with that for the next episode. Isn't that right next to our fucking castle? It looks very similar. Okay, doesn't matter, but the views are pretty amazing, being honest. Okay, but we'll be ending this episode right here. So, if you liked it, give it a like. If you disliked it, give a dislike. But also write me a comment saying what I did wrong, so that I might be better in the future. If you have any tips, tricks, ideas, anything like that, give me a comment. And if you want to see more content like that, then please subscribe. That will be it for this episode. I will thank you all for watching. And of course, see you in the next one. Bye-bye.